Waiting until your 30s to have children used to be a rarity. Nowadays, more than half of first-time Aussie mums fall into that bracket. But as we wait till later in life and have fewer kids, what does that mean for the future of our country?
We've heard it from JB. Baby, 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 oh. We've heard it from Peter Costello.
I have one for mum, one for dad, and one for the country.
But 20 years on from the then-Treasurer's landmark baby bonus policy, and Australians still aren't having enough babies. Research revealing we've hit a near-record low fertility rate. The average Aussie expected to have 1.6 babies over the next 5 years, well below the international average of 2.3.
I'm not going to be contributing to the 1.6.
The dip's been put down to widespread use of contraception, women having the agency to start having kids later, and the fact that raising them has become far more expensive, costing up to around $1 million to raise two children.
The average salary is not enough in one family to get by.
And space. We don't have backyards anymore.
An average rate of 2.1 babies is needed for our population to remain steady without immigration. But the way we're going, the number of children will be outnumbered by people over 65 in just 10 years.
There are a number of factors that do weigh on the minds of parents or parents-to-be, and they are things like the rising housing unaffordability problem, having a hex debt, wages not growing that quickly.
Experts say the trend could see severe impacts on our workforce, healthcare system, and cultural makeup.
We've ended up reaching for the migration lever to grow our population, and we might, in the short term, plug some of our job or skill shortages, but in the long term, we're going to have fewer people in our schools, fewer people moving into the workforce.
And other countries have started tackling these issues head-on, including Japan, South Korea, and China, which have even lower fertility rates than us.
What Japan has had to do is rely on technology and productivity to make up for the shortfalls in labour. We've got AI coming along, we've got a lot of automation which will help, but whether we can just rely on technology alone as we face mass retirement remains to be seen.
So, do we need another Costello-esque scheme to get more Aussies back on the baby train or face the reality of a rapidly ageing population?
Things like a baby bonus, they do have a short-term positive impact, but it is systemic reform to paid parental leave and early education and care. Those longer-term reforms are likely to have a more significant and long-term impact on the birth rate.